What's up, guys? I'm going to show you how to use the path tracer in your renderings. Let's get right into the video. All right, guys, there's a couple of things that we need to do first before we initiate our path tracer. So first thing is, let's go to the image that's already created. We'll go to the living room space. All right, so we got our image already set up, and if you go over here to our panel, you see different options. You have your environment, you have your camera, you have your rendering settings, you have the FX and your image. So we're gonna go through some of these settings to kind of make our image look appealing, and while we're at it, we're gonna use the path tracer today. So let's get started. Okay, so first thing is, let's look in our environment tab, kind of see what options we have here. We've got global lighting. We're gonna keep that at 1030. I like where that's at currently. Sun intensity, let's bring it down to 5. We're going to change our ambient to 2, and then white balance, let's change it to 5500. Okay. So that kind of sets the mood a little bit. And then we're going to go to camera, and right now our focal length is at 13. Let's change it to 22. I'm not gonna enable our depth of field this time around. We only wanna use that if we're gonna do like a close-up image. And in this case, we're not gonna use that. And we're gonna go to wing editing. I don't want any dark shadows around the corners of my image in this one. So I'm gonna keep it at 0. Let's put that at 25%. And we're gonna bump up our sharpness to about 25 as well. Now, anytime you're doing a rendering, always make sure that parallelism is checked. Skip over rendering because that's where we're going to use the path tracer. We're not going to get there quite yet. Let's go to FX, and right now we have a contrast of 31%. I'm going to let's look at 60%. We'll see how that really brightens up the space a whole lot. Then our saturation, we'll keep that at 65%. Then we're going to go to our color gradient. And we have several different options here. I'm going to use filter. And then a filter, or there's no need for a filter in this one. Okay. Let's make sure that we update our own. Let's see. And just kind of looking back through my settings, I think the exposure is good at 1. Something local exposure. Got that enable, that looks good. Okay, we're not gonna mess with any of our settings here. Definitely wanna keep the backdrop on HDRI. Intensity, we can keep it at 100, rotation to 15. We're going to lock our sun to the HDRI as well. We're going to use the preview noon grass. Okay. All that looks good so far. let's get into our path tracer. So right now, as you can see, we're in Lumen, and right now this is not a Lumen tutorial, so we'll show you how to do Lumen next time and changing up some of these settings in Lumen to get a really nice quality image. Right now we're gonna do path tracer, so let's click on path tracer. And as you can see right now, the pixels are converging to try to go ahead and populate a nice image. But as you can see, the samples per pixel is at 64 and the max bounces are at 8, so the missing materials, the noiser. So there's some settings that we need to go ahead and fix here, because right now you see a static image. And some of you are probably wondering, like, what's going on? So first off, you can enable the path tracer from your panel, or you can enable the path tracer at the top here in your shortcut bar. So right now the path tracer is enabled, but we're going to change some of these settings. So we want a high image. We're going to crank it up to 800 and max bounce 15. And then we want to click on our emissive materials. That's the way that the materials are influenced by bouncing of the light. And then the reason why the path tracer looked like it wasn't working is because we didn't have remove image noise. So you always want to have your denoiser on, checked on. Okay, so fireflies right now we got 15. I'm gonna push that up to 30. And now we should definitely get a clearer and better image this time around. Guys, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe, hit that notification bell. I'm definitely going to be bringing some more tutorials your way, so hang in for that and stick around for some new digital products that I'm going to be releasing soon as well. All right, so right now it's kind of a little bit of a waiting game, but if you got a powerful computer, it's not going to take too much time. And right now we're at 800 samples per pixel, and that is a very, very high quality image. And here we go. And as you can see, you get a real nice quality image here.